In this lecture, we will discuss different causes of defect. There are two main focus of this discussion: normal cause of defect and environmental cause of defect. First, we will have a look into normal defect causes. And here we have six different causes of failure. The first one is time pressure. If you are working in an environment where you are given very little time to complete your task, then it is possible that you will overlook certain things that may cause a defect. And the second one is human fallibility. As a human, we all are fallible, because fallible means likely to make error or fail. Nobody is perfect over here, and this can introduce an error in the software. The third cause is inexperienced and insufficiently skilled people. If you are working in an organization where there are people without sufficient knowledge of the project, then it may result in a defect. The fourth cause is miscommunication or misunderstanding. If your organization lacks proper channel of communication, this could lead to a defect. The fifth one is complexity of the code, design, and architecture. This means even if you have an experienced people in your team, but if the code is very complex, then you might end up making an error. And the last cause is new unfamiliar technologies. If you are working with a technology that you don't know enough about, then this can also result in a defect. So these were the six causes of defect. Now let's move to the environmental causes. So the first cause is radiation. Precedence of radiation can cause a defect. The next one is electromagnetic field. We all know how on flight we are asked to switch off our mobile phones. This is to avoid electromagnetic interference. And the third one is pollution. So if there are dust particles on the sensor, it could result in an error readings. And similarly, there could be many other environmental causes.